all across the globe, we find the modern day people have awakened to very nice things now. For example, people have started understanding, you know, one boy had a t-shirt I saw. Live echo, leave ego. That was a t-shirt.
Okay, beautiful. Environmental consciousness. Yeah.
I was saying, my spiritual master said the same thing when I went to GV once. He said, every jiva is hankering for, you know, ego-friendly relationships. And they want to live in eco-friendly environment. You are saying.
Oh, beautiful.
So I heard it 5 years ago, but this boy is having in his t-shirt, you know, live echo, leave ego. That means, you know, many modern day people hate egotistic people. They are looking for simple people, friendly people, you know, courteous people, kind people who will not unnecessarily, you know, insult you or misbehave with you. Therefore, they wear on the t-shirt on being human. Okay. You can see that. So that means that people are looking for satisfied with oneself and being sensitive with others. That kind of relationship people are looking for. So they are looking for good relationships, and people are looking for programs not in concrete buildings, but they're looking for programs where it's eco-friendly environment. So if you take them to a farm or a, you know, where there is nice grass lawn, or there are they can do some trekking in the mountain, or there is a water body, they can swim, you know, and also you have cottages where you can do a Bhagavad Gita class program, and more number of people come for such a, you know, retreat type of thing, rather than if you do it in a concrete building, not many people are happy to come. So, and what are they eager to learn? They want to know how to manage their mind. Like I had given 40 topics, one-time program topics to IIT Bombay. They chose this art of harnessing mind power. That's what they have chosen. Which goes to show that people want to know mind is like an elephant. You know, elephant can be good, elephant can be bad. A good elephant gives ashirwad. You know, a good elephant can take you on its back. A good elephant can carry trunks of wood for the human beings and be good friends with humans. You can even walk elephant on the road. But can you walk a lion on the road? You cannot. On the other hand, the same elephant, when it becomes mad, it can take scooters and break it. It can break down cars. It can kill people, isn't it? So people want to know how to manage the mind. So one is the mind management. They want to know how to learn good habits, pure habits. People are getting obesity problem. They want to learn how to be slim and how to control the six urges. So we have a nectar of instruction, such wonderful knowledge. And we also have three atepa austerities in Bhagavad Gita, 17.14, 15, 16 verses. Satyam. So people want to learn self-management. They want to learn self-development. They want to learn mind management. They want to restrain the bestial emotions like anger management and anger and lust and greed. Ambition is good, but over-ambition is never good. Ambition is like stretch zone. Over-ambition is a panic zone. So people understand that panic zone is no good. So how to have, thumping emotions in life without burning out ourselves. People want to know, like when I was in Boston.
So broadly, articulate what you're saying is, you could say this whole genre can be called something like self-help or self-development or self-improvement.
Yes, correct.
So this is an area where
most people are looking for.
Yeah, a large number of people are looking for. And in one sense, we could say Christians have capitalized on this area hugely.
Yeah.
Even before I was introduced to Krishna consciousness, a book I had read was about the power of positive thinking. That was by Norman Vincent Peale. And it's considered a classic. And he talks about positive thinking, but brings in Christian values in that. And so I think this whole area, it is huge.
Yeah.
And there are some other, we could say, Hindu or Vedic groups have also tapped it significantly. So recently
I did a 10 part series called Self-Development series.
Self-development.
Each Sunday, I have 1,400 people registered for that. So 10 Sundays, successive Sundays we did. Now, beginning with self-awareness, then self-management, then overcoming inferiority complex, overcoming superiority complex, thinking, art of thinking, win-win, abundance mentality, self-care, all these things, everything about the self. And people really loved it. People are looking for, as you rightly said, they are looking for self-improvement and self-development. Also, people are feeling a lot of inferiority complex because of cutthroat competition nowadays. So they want to know you know, how to live in this world and live in this competitive world. That's another thing people want to know. Without, you know, getting diseased in the mind with inferiority complex, you know, or without hurting ourselves, how to live in the world. Therefore, I put it very precisely. People are looking for, you know, self-development as well as healthy relationships with others.
Okay.
Actually, we have a lot to offer in Krishna consciousness because we teach personal values, interpersonal values, social values and spiritual values. We have information about all these four in the Shastra.